Hello, and thanks for joining me. I'm Mark Mitchell, and welcome to my virtual artist talk. In this video, I'll be sharing a bit about my background, my creative influences, and a look at my painting process, and some insights into what I'm aiming to achieve through my work. My origin story? Well, I'm one of those people who's always felt I've been an artist. I've always been drawing or creating something as long as I can remember. By age 12, I was making my own animated cartoons in my basement, with paper cutouts like you see on Monty Python and South Park. Later, I graduated Pratt Institute in New York City, where my focus was graphic design and illustration. For many years, I made my career as an art director in New York ad agencies. I ultimately relocated to St. Petersburg, Florida, to shift gears and pursue my dream of being a fine artist. I call myself a conceptual pop painter and multimedia artist. Yeah, it's kind of a mouthful. Let me break it down for you. My primary focus is as a painter, specifically a pop painter. I create bold, colorful work, following in the tradition of some of my heroes and influences, like Andy Warhol, Roy Lichtenstein, Keith Haring, James Rosenquist, my personal favorite, Milton Glaser, the godfather of modern graphic design. I drew my own version of this one, Glaser's iconic Bob Dylan image, in first grade, in crayon, from memory of the poster that hung on my brother's bedroom wall at the time. I also love surrealism, especially the work of René Magritte and Salvador Dali. I love the soft focus realism of Edward Hopper, and the urban styles and social commentary of street artists like Shepard Fairey, Ron English, and Banksy, to name just a few. So, when you put it all together, you get a conceptual pop painter. Then, if you throw in a few more skills and interests like singer-songwriter, voiceover artist, art director, digital artist, video producer, you've got a conceptual pop painter and multimedia artist. So that's me. I created the mark behind me to help communicate uniqueness, the handmade quality, and the human perspective I try to convey through my paintings. Here's a quick look at my work. So, what's the big idea? The art that's always appealed to me is not just a pretty picture. It's founded in an idea, something that grabs your attention and actually makes you think. Picasso's Guernica shed light on the effects of a violent revolution. Dali's The Persistence of Memory challenged our perception of space and time. Magritte's The Treachery of Images reminded us a pipe is not a pipe when it's simply a painting of one. And Warhol's Campbell soup cans forced us to reconsider exactly what art is or can be. In every artist's journey comes the aha moment, the one that hits you like a lightning bolt and makes everything clear. For me, it was the first time I saw Rosenquist's House of Fire at the Met in New York. I was amazed by the bold, colorful imagery on such a grand scale. I discovered the artist was a former billboard painter and had decided to mash up those commercial images to a mysterious effect rather than use them to sell us something we may not need. As a student of both art and advertising, it spoke to me. The key is juxtaposition. By contrasting unexpected images, art can create tension while teasing the curiosity of the viewer. I decided this was the approach I wanted to explore with my work, while putting my own spin on it. My first painting in this new body of work remains one of my most popular pieces. I was intrigued at how fireworks, like clouds, can sometimes resemble other imagery, like waterfalls, swimming fish, or palm trees. I decided to combine these two images since they both elicit a similar sense of celebration. State of Independence captures my feelings of freedom as I transition from my New York ad career to life as a Florida artist. My approach to the canvas involves masking off certain areas, isolating elements, and creating sharp edges, which adds to the collage effect. My rendering technique requires building up many layers of tonality, starting with the darkest shadows and gradually creating dimension by adding a range of midtones, then highlights. This piece, Power and Grace, is an homage to the modern woman. In the final diptych, a ballet dancer represents both femininity and inner strength, while a power drill symbolizes her intensity and endurance. In building a body of work, I've explored a range of social issues, from corporate greed to environmentalism to personal empowerment, and most often, modern technology and its effects on human behavior. Ultimately, my goal is to encourage people to look deeper. Each piece is designed to invite the viewer in, challenge them to find meaning, and ultimately see the world a little differently. Over the years, I've been lucky to have had a few successes. I had the pleasure of exhibiting during Art Basel Miami and Armory Arts Week in New York. My work was jury selected by pop surrealist master Ron English. I've presented a few large-scale solo shows in the Tampa Bay area, participated in gallery shows in Los Angeles, West Palm Beach, and Baton Rouge, and amazingly, even had my work displayed at the Louvre in Paris. I've sold internationally, created public art and corporate commissions, been interviewed on TV, and won a few grants and awards along the way as well. And for all this, I'm extremely grateful, as I am to you for watching. So join me on my journey. Find me on Facebook and YouTube at Mark Mitchell Studio, on Instagram and Twitter at MM Studio Art, and on my main website, markmitchellstudio.com, where you can join my mailing list to keep up to date. There's much more to come, so stay tuned and look deeper.